Kids, bless their hearts, will touch just about anything. Wet, dirty, slimy, it really doesn't matter. These curious little explorers will stop at nothing when it comes to understanding everything the world has to offer, especially if it seems that it's potentially dangerous. Which is why, in September 2018, two New Zealand parents rushed to stop their kids from touching an alien-like blob that was washed up on a beach. Then, intrigued by the mystery of what the heck the purple mass lying in the sand was, the family decided to investigate. As soon as the Dickinson family, which is comprised of Adam, Eve, and their two kids, stepped onto the Auckland, New Zealand's Pakiri Beach, they saw this purple blob in the sand. They had no idea what it was, or what it was capable of. So naturally, the two kids, Sophia and Lucas, sprinted over to it with all the reckless abandon of children on a mission to satisfy their curiosities about something wildly unsafe and potentially dangerous. This concerned Adam and Eve, who didn't wish to see their children succumb to a purple, potentially poisonous beach blob, so they too approached the mysterious thing in the sand. My initial thought was, "Don't let my kids touch it," Adam told the news sometime after the ordeal. With the family of four now all gathered around the mystery substance, they all echoed the same question. What the heck was it? The Dickinsons launched an informal investigation. The first thing that they'd noticed was that the purple blob was pulsating, moving. Like Frankenstein's monster, it was alive. It almost looked like a load of muscles contracting, Adam recalled. It was pretty incredible and really hard to describe. Meanwhile, the kids were reminded of something oddly specific when they looked at the blob. Lucas told his mom that the creature looked like a volcano. It had, after all, sloping sides and what looked like a crater of bubbling purple lava. This was obviously no volcano, so the Dickinsons investigated further. Despite their initial concerns about the pulsating creature, the family, to our benefit, proceeded to place check after check on the list of things you should not do to foreign, potentially dangerous things. For instance, Lucas and Sophia blew on the thing. To the kids' delights, the more they blew on the creature, the more that it moved, confirming that, yes, it was very much alive and was very much aware of outside stimuli. With this understanding, the Dickinsons grabbed a stick and prodded the blob. Sure enough, Eve recalled that the creature moved even more when the stick prodded its meat. While the kids poked, prodded, and blew on the creature, Adam and Eve noticed something peculiar about the beach. Tons of jellyfish were scattered around the shore. This answered the question, right? See, for a moment, they thought their mystery creature was just a jellyfish washed ashore. But still, their pulsating friend looked nothing like the other jellyfish. Maybe their guy was just upside down or something. So with their stick, the Dickinsons flipped over some of the other jellyfish that had washed up on the shore, hoping that this would prove that their creature was just a really big, really upside-down jellyfish. But even upside down, the landlocked jellyfish still looked nothing like the captivating creature that had so entranced the family. They were back to square one, so eventually the marine experts chimed in with answers. A member of New Zealand's National Institute of Water and Atmospheric Research, Diana McPherson, knew almost instantly what this common creature was. The purple pulsating blob that had entranced Adam, Eve, Sophia, and Lucas on the jellyfish-laden shores of Pakiri Beach was, according to Diana, the largest species of jellyfish found in New Zealand's waters, the lion's mane jellyfish. These huge jellyfish can grow as big as 7 feet wide, with tentacles 100 feet long. These long tentacles give it a sort of lion's mane, hence the creature's name. As it turned out, Adam was right to want to keep his kids away initially. While these jellyfish aren't deadly, their tentacles carry toxins that can deliver some serious welts to those unfortunate enough to get caught in the mane. This particular jellyfish was also a bit of an oddity. Normally, lion's manes wash up on the shore in summer or spring, when plankton start blooming. This one washed up in autumn. Whatever the odds of a lion's mane washing up in September, the Dickinsons were delighted with the experience. It was incredible, Adam recalled.